हेलो एवरीवन, इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू सी अबाउट सिंगल फेज स्टेपर मोटर एंड द वेरियस एप्लीकेशंस ऑफ द स्टेपर मोटर। So these are the some contents of this presentation, single phase stepper motor and applications of stepper motor. Single phase stepper motor. These are the motors which are designed to be operated from single phase supply. They are widely used in watches and clocks, timers and counters. Present single phase stepper motors use one or more, that is two, permanent magnets, because permanent magnets are quite necessary to raise the ratio of torque to input power in a miniature motor. The two requirements of single phase stepper motor are to detent the motor at a particular position when the coil is not excited. And the second requirement, to rotate the motor at desired direction by switching the magnetic polarity of only one coil. Next is construction. It is a permanent magnet type stepper motor with two poles. Rotor is a circular type of permanent magnet as shown in the figure. You can see on the screen, you can see two different figures are there. On left side figure you can see single phase stepper motor, and on right side you can see detent position and coil polarity to rotate the motor. So first we will see the rotor is a circular type of permanent magnet as shown in this first figure. Okay, here you can see rotor. The stator is made up of silicon steel stampings with two salient poles. Stator carries a coil which is connected to the pulsed supply. The air gap is specially designed so that specific reluctance at different radial axes is different. The minimum values occur at one tip of the poles. Under normal conditions, the rotor occupies any one of the descent position. Here in this figure you can see detent position and coil polarity. So under normal conditions, the rotor occupies any one of the descent position as shown in this figure. A and B we will consider to minimum reluctance position. Two positions shown in figure A and B, and they are detent positions of the rotor of stator motor, stepper motor. Okay, here you if you can see, the direction is in this way and here opposite direction is there. And if we see position of poles, here the north pole is in this side and south pole is opposite to that. But in figure B, the position of pole is different or reversed. Here south pole is there and north pole is in this side. Okay, these are the detent positions. If we consider the principle of operation of the single phase stepper motor, when the coil is given an electric positive pulse, pole A in position 1 as shown in figure, it experiences a torque in clockwise direction and finally attains a steady state. Then pulse given to the coil is 0. After a lapse of second from the start of the pulse, a negative pulse is given to the coil, which makes the both pole A as a south and pole B as a north. Okay. Rotor experiences another torque. By repeating the cycle, the rotor rotates continuously in a step. It is not possible to develop torque in counterclockwise direction by altering the pulses. So, this is about the single phase stepper motor, the construction and its basics, requirement as well as working principle. Then we will see the applications of stepper motor. The main applications of stepper motor may be divided into the different groups. First one is instrumentation application, computer peripherals and office equipments, then numeric control of machine tools and robotics, then application in semiconductor technology, space vehicles and satellites, then electromedical and miscellaneous applications. Okay, these are the some categories in which stepper motor is used. Okay. And we will see first one, instrumentation application. This involves low torque application such as quartz watches, synchronized clocks and camera shutter operations. Okay, these are the some instrumentation applications. Next is stepper motor application in computer peripherals, this involves medium torque, high performance and high volume application such as dot matrix and line printers, graph plotters, floppy disk drivers, digital XY plotters, magnetic tape drives, paper tape drives, etc. Next is application in office equipment. So, electronic typewriters, copiers, etc. Next is machine tool applications. This involves high torque application such as numerical control system for milling machine, XY tables and index table, home use and industrial sewing machines. Okay, these are the some machine tool applications. Next is application in semiconductor technology. Stepper motors used in high vacuum, an instrument used to determine crystalline structure, electron beam microfabricator. So this is for semiconductor technology. Next is stepper motor used in space vehicles and satellites, as well as it is used in robotics area. Next area is electromedical applications. This involves high torque applications such as X-ray machines, radiation therapy units and ultrasound scanner. Last point is miscellaneous applications. So here nuclear reactors, heavy industry applications and automatic focusing mechanism in camera. These are the some applications considered as miscellaneous applications. So here we have seen some applications of stepper motor and about single phase stepper motor. So now we will just see some important points regarding stepper motor, because we have covered almost all points regarding the stepper motor, which is part of first chapter. So we will just revise some key points. So first is stepper motor. The stepper motor is a brushless DC motor whose rotor rotates in discrete displacement when its stator windings are energized in a programmer manner. The rotor has no winding, magnets or case winding. Next is full step operation. Single phase on mode is the one in which at time only one phase winding is energized. Next is step angle. It is the angular displacement of the rotor of stepper motor for every pulse of excitation given to the stator windings of the motor. Then resolution. It is the number of steps per revolution. Okay, resolution is the number of steps per revolution. Then stepping rate or frequency is the number of steps per second. Is the stepping rate or frequency. So now next is hold position. It is corresponds to the rest position when the stepper motor is excited or energized. Next is stepping error. Stepping error is the actual step angle is slightly different from the theoretical step angle. Next is positional error. The maximum range of cumulative percentage of error taken over a complete rotation of stepper motor. Then holding torque, it is the maximum load torque which the energized stepper motor can withstand slipping from equilibrium position. Then detent torque, it is the maximum load torque which the unenergized stepper motor can withstand without slipping. Sorry. So I will repeat: holding torque and detent torque. Holding torque is the maximum load torque which the energized stepper motor can withstand slipping from equilibrium position, and in detent torque it is the maximum load torque which unenergized stepper motor can withstand without slipping. Okay, in holding torque energized stepper motor is there, and in detent torque unenergized stepper motor. In holding torque withstand slipping, and in detent torque withstand without slipping. Okay, this difference is there. Then next is static stiffness. Okay, what is static stiffness? It is the ability of actuator to resist disturbing torques and forces and thereby to maintain a position. Okay, static stiffness is the ability of actuator to resist disturbing torques and forces and thereby to maintain position. The next is bandwidth. Bandwidth it is a measure of the frequencies up to which the actuator or servo system can respond. Okay, actuator or servo system can respond to the frequencies, and that is that measure of frequencies is a bandwidth. Next is synchronism. It is the 1-to-1 correspondence between the number of pulses applied to the stepper motor and the number of steps through which the motor has actually moved. Okay, synchronism is the correspondence between the number of pulses applied to stepper motor and the number of steps through which the motor has actually moved. Next is half step operation. Half step operation, it is the alternate one phase on and two phase on mode operation. Here the rotor rotates through half of the full step angle. Okay, it is alternate one phase on and two phase on mode operation, and rotor rotates through half of the full step angle. Okay, we have seen what is step angle. Next is slewing. Stepper motor may operate high stepping rates, that is 25,000 steps per second. Okay, these are the some key points or important terms regarding the stepper motor. So in this video we have seen about single phase stepper motor, its basic, then construction and working principle, and various applications of the stepper motors in various areas, and then important or key points regarding stepper motor. So in next video we will start next point or next type of motor. So here, thank you. Thank you for watching this video.